Hello there, my cancer friends. It's Anna here. I am done with my tea though because it is almost my bedtime. But I am gonna bang out one more reading for the night for this full moon that we have coming up on Sunday. So, my cancer friends, we are going to look at what you need to release or let go with this full moon, okay? What kind of transformation needs to take place in order for you to reach your fullest potential? What's being illuminated right now or coming to light for you with the full moon? And then we're going to get a message for you from the universe. I have the last of this one stick of incense burning, and I tell you, it smells friggin' amazing. I love it. I love it. It's called Seven Angels by Green Tree. It's like from the Netherlands. I got it from this little shop that's local to me called Mariposa Fairies. And like for each, so there's an angel for each day, right? And then it comes with like a little angelic invocation, right? So this is Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. So today's Wednesday, so it's Archangel Gabriel. It says, I protect and guide you on Wednesday. I sharpen your intuitions and discernment. I show you the correct path for the fulfillment of your missions. I purify your soul and help you in promoting yourself as a pure and trustworthy individual. And it's the same thing on the other side. Here I was like, oh, maybe one side's going to be French and the other side's going to be English, but it's not. So then it just continues like Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and then back to Sunday on the first one. But it smells so good. It's Green Tree. Green Tree. And here we are, the Netherlands. But if you're local to me, if you're in like the Niagara area, Mariposa Fairies, she's in the same town as me. I think she's Mariposa Fairies Etsy on Instagram, so look her up. It's Bonnie and Bev. All these lovely pretties you see here, well, most of them anyways, were acquired through them. Beautiful stuff. Beautiful. All right. So let's see, for my cancer friends, for this full moon, what they need to release, what's transforming for them, what's being illuminated, and their message. Oh, well, that's interesting. So what you're needing to release is the King of Cups in reverse. Okay, let's just be honest here. So if the King of Cups were upright, it's a very like emotional, empathetic person. Okay, supportive, right? But when you reverse it, this person can sometimes be someone like my ex. No, I'm just kidding. No, I'm not really. I don't know why I said that. It's true. They can be emotionally manipulative, okay? Abusive, and probably use all of the most minuscule tactics to try and make it seem like they're not, but they are, right? So anybody who's, look up abuse, look up situations that seriously are considered abusive. There's so many different kinds of abuse. I had no idea until I got out of my marriage and I started going to counseling. There's an insane amount, right? There's like There's psychological, there's financial, there's social, there's sexual, there's, did I say social already? I think I said social already. There's physical, right? And the smallest of things, like I was like, oh, I've never experienced social abuse because he would never do anything in public for anybody else to see. But, like, did you know that sitting with somebody in a restaurant or a bar and having them turn their back to you and have a conversation with somebody else instead of, you know, holding off on that conversation for a later time and keeping their full attention with the person that they're with is a form of social abuse. Do you know how many times I went out to, like, the bar where all of his friends were, and I'd be sitting next to him and literally would get his back as he had a conversation with one of his friends? Do you know how many times that happened? Oh my gosh. I had no idea. No idea. No, he would never do anything out in public. But there are things that if it triggers you, it triggers you for a reason, okay? So look, my Cancer friends, at what triggers you right now. Because whatever triggers you is not meant for you. And you need to let it go, okay? And that's all I've got to say about that before it triggers me. Because, you know. Okay, transformation. How to reach my full potential. That's going to be with the community, my Cancer friends. All right? You're going to have to rely on somebody else other than yourself. Okay, the Four of Wands is all about a homecoming, right? Four is a very, like, stable number. Four is, like, foundation stability, right? Four corners of a house, right? Things stabilize when you have them evenly distributed between four corners. Okay? So this is family, this is friends, this is reunions, this is community. Okay? So that is how. So maybe you have felt isolated by a certain person in your life. Maybe they do some things that make you feel like you're alone. Okay? I don't know how else to say this. You're not. There are resources in your community, wherever you may be, that will help you out. Okay? There's community that will help you. So whoever this person is who makes you feel like this, whoever this person is who may throw this manipulation, this abusive blah, 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 emotional abuse at you, you need to find support in your community, okay? You need to find stability, okay? It is there to be had, it is there to be found, trust me. At one point in my life, I did not think that I could ever do what I am doing right now. At one point in my life, I never imagined that I would leave my husband. He was the major breadwinner. I was home taking care of the kids. We had decided if I was going to work that it would just be to pay for daycare, and that didn't make any sense. It didn't make any sense to have somebody else other than one of their parents raise them. So we decided I would stay home, and I did. So he was the major breadwinner. And when somebody else is your major, like, money maker, it's really hard to find a way to save for yourself or to get out of that situation. But more people in that situation, and not just women, okay, because there are women who also abuse men. If Amber Heard and Johnny Depp have taught us nothing, then it's at least that, right? So there are ways out of it. And find your community, find your people to talk to, find those people. They will help you. Okay? All right. What is being illuminated or coming to life for you right now, my Cancer friends? And that is the Ten of Pentacles. Pentacles are all about the earth, so it's all about the material, the things here in the physical world. Okay? And this is like the tree of life. This is everything. This is like everything you could ever want is here on this card, right? You've got your loyal companion that you've had for years. You've got grandkids, right? He's I think got whitish hair there, so these may be kids, but I think they also might be grandkids. I think they've made them look that way to kind of insinuate that, if anything, right? But yeah, this is like the makings of a legacy. Right? This is everything that you could ever want in the material world. And it doesn't have to be a lot. Okay? You don't have to have a mansion and half a dozen cars and a boat and a yacht and a summer home and all of this stuff, right? Everything you could ever want, your Ten of Pentacles could be a perfect family. Laughing children running around your house, whether they're your kids or your grandkids, it doesn't matter. Okay? It's yes, pentacles are, of the physical world. However, it's not always just money stuff. Doesn't just have to have monetary value. Because you could take a monetary value and say, well, my family is priceless. There's no number you could put on that, right? So, maybe you have family that you do need to take care of, and maybe getting away from whatever energy this is going to allow you to become stable and realize this for yourself. And I hope that you can do it, Cancers. I truly do. It was the best decision I honestly ever made. It truly was. And then your message from the universe is the Queen of Pentacles. Right? She is resourceful, very resourceful. So, you know that there are resources out there. And I talked about finding the resources that would be able to help you get out of a situation. And then you've got the Queen of Resourcefulness right here, right? Popping up as your message from the universe, right? She's got everything covered. You know what to do, Cancer. Make a list and get it done. I know it's going to be difficult. It's not going to be easy. It never is, especially when you're dealing with the ending of something. And this is a big something, right? This is a big something. So, I'm sorry if that resonates with you. And I hope that you can find the resources to get this stability for your future. All right, my Cancer friends, I hope this finds you well. I hope you enjoy the full moon on Sunday, and we will talk to you soon. Bye for now.